Thank you for your valor and bravery. The enemy was strong, but you were stronger. And that means I made the right choice. Just as I thought, there were worthy leaders among you. I'm especially grateful to them for the courage and common sense they showed while defending the mansion. But this attack means we have even less time than I thought. Someone already knows of our plans and is acting against us. You'll begin your expedition immediately.
Lady Aldori, please, I know who arranged this attack. The vile king of Pitax, Iroveti. What's more, I know who among us works for him. Hey, you! Show everyone the ring you're wearing. You think I wouldn't recognize Iroveti's seal? That's why she wasn't killed. The bandits recognized her as one of their own by this signet ring.
Yes. Such a gambit would be typical of Iroveti and his henchmen. And yet, it still seems suspicious. There's definitely a spy among us. But who? All I have is one word against another. I'm afraid you're both under suspicion.
They both came to your aid, Lady Jamandi. But a liar's cunning knows no bounds. I've never met these two or their companions. For all I know, they're all conspiring spies.
How could you say that? We fought together. We literally went through fire together. And then you vanished into thin air. After you promised you'd wait.
My words might be rash.
I bet my life espies anyone but this woman. I saw how she dealt with those creeps with my own eyes. A true warrior. I'd go with her through hell and high water. This purple crook, on the other hand. He's got the eyes of a spy. And the mug of a spy!
Lady Aldori, don't listen to this thick-headed barbarian. She doesn't know what she's talking about. During the attack, our leader showed her true colors. She forced us to break into the armory and rob it. And not just that. Upon finding the guard's salaries in the armory, she immediately pocketed it all.
I see you don't scare easily. You'll do well in the stolen lands. But I'm going to have to ask you to return the money.
Of course, theft is not to be condoned. But when the fire burns around you, and you are but one step away from death, would it not be insane to worry about laws and rules? I see this not as a crime, but as a unique wisdom visiting us as we stood at the face of oblivion.
There is a difference between initiative taken in battle and blatant arrogation. How can someone who disregards authorities be a leader herself?
What about that trick she pulled right before we came in here? Some scoundrels set your mansion on fire, and as we were approaching the room, we saw your brave guards, your underlings, dying in the fire, begging to be saved. And what did our leader do? She passed right on by, mercilessly leaving them to their fates. Simply heartless.
Leaving them to die bought you mere minutes. Believe me, I would have held on until your arrival.
It was perfectly reasonable. Just the way a leader should think.
How could you say such a monstrous thing? Is that the way the hero of my book would talk? You sound more like a villain.
Enough squabbling! I'm still not sure which of you I can trust. However, the risk of entrusting the whole affair to a spy is too great. Here's what we'll do. Two teams will head out. That way, I'll know at least one group can be counted on to serve my interests in the stolen lands.
Lady Aldori, most of those who were to set off for the stolen lands have been killed. Those who yet live will require help. Please allow me to join the expedition.
I'm sad to lose such a talented warrior. But you're right, Valerie. They have greater need of you right now. Go, and may Abadar keep you. Which of the two teams would you prefer to accompany?
If Tartuccio allows, I would join his team. Forgive me, but I don't appreciate your willfulness.
And I like our leader. What wisdom lies in minding orders, laws, and rules in the face of oblivion, knowing not whether you'll be alive tomorrow? I will go with her team.
I like how our leader does things. Efficient, and without unnecessary spiritual agonizing. I'll go with her.
Efficient? I'd say heartless. Would the protagonist of my book do such a thing? No. I guess I'd better go with Tartuccio.
As for me, I know neither of these two. At least, not well enough. And I have no wish to become an unwitting pawn to an unworthy leader. If Lady Jamandi allows, I'll remain in Restov and help mend the wounds this attack has inflicted. But who knows? The road may bring me to the stolen lands, but not yet.
I don't even need to think. I'm coming with this woman. As for you, Purple Toad, just wait until we meet along the way. I'll be sure to hang your rotten spy guts from the trees.
All right, we have two teams. To avoid unnecessary conflict on the road, you'll each take a different route to the stolen lands. Tartuccio's team will go through Navakta's Crossing. The garrison commandant will provide him all the help he needs. You will take your team to Oleg Levitin's trading post. He's been complaining about the Staglord's bandits for a while now. There, you'll be provided with all the necessary travel supplies. I'd like to believe you, but I know all too well how convincing traitors and spies can be. If you're truly innocent, I hope you can forgive me this precaution. While you're away, Keston will investigate the night's events and learn who in Restov is working for Patox. But you should know that it isn't just Patox we need to worry about. The Royal House of Sertova may also interfere in our plans. I've managed to keep this affair a secret from them so far, but that can't last long. By my estimations, you have no more than 3 months. After that, any feats you accomplish will be pointless. And now, farewell. This battle was but the first ordeal along your path, and you overcame it as true champions of Restov. May the obstacles that follow also fall to your feet. Fear nothing, my friends, and return victorious.
Surviving a terrible night, our small team set off to brave our fate. Beware, stolen lands. Heroes are on the way.
Thank you.
Who cannot stand against me?
Them apart!
Unworthy.
Let the attack commence!
Despicable. Thank you.
request.
Oh, sorry.
Let's shake a leg.
Share your will.
Ask.
So many thoughts.
What
so
you want?
Little time.
Patience.